Okay, in the previous class we talked about some of the conflicts that can happen because we have styles that can be implemented at various stages. Like it would be like a cascading. So at many levels, you have the styles can be provided. So there would be a conflict, and how those conflicts will be handled. So there are different principles that are followed. Okay, one is inheritance. We talked about that inheritance. Second one, specificity. How specific is that particular style? And next one is the location, where it is located. So inheritance. Yesterday we saw that if parent has certain style, the child is going to inherit that. Okay, descendant rather than the child, descendants. All the descendants are going to inherit the certain properties of the parent. For here example, body is the parent. It has a property like a font, color. Those are inherited, and there are certain properties that are not inherited. For example, border, margin, okay, layout, things like that. Those are not inherited. You saw the example also, how the inheritance happens. We saw this example with the code. Okay. Next one is the specificity. What is specificity is how specific is that particular style? Okay, based on the more specific the style is, that particular style will be given more precedence, or that particular style will be applied. Specificity is how the browser determines which style rule takes precedence when more than one style rule could be applied to same element. The more specific the selector, the more it takes the precedence. That is, it overrides the previous definitions. Whichever is very specific. For example, let us say you have like a external file is there, CSS file. You have the style mentioned, let's say font. For font size, font weight, whatever it could be, and also you have mentioned it as a embedded in the head section, and also you have as a inline, okay, as a in the inside the HTML tag you have a inline style. What will happen is inline style is more specific, so whatever is there in the inline style, that particular style will be applied to that HTML tag. The way that specificity works in the browser is that the browser assigns a weight to each style rule. When several rules apply, the one with the greatest weight takes precedence. So, what does browser do? Browser assigns a certain weight for each of the styles, and the weight is calculated, and whichever is having the more weight, we will see how that weight is assigned. Whichever is having the highest weight, that particular style will be applied. Okay, you can see here we have a different styles here specified. We have a body. Okay, this is the HTML head. We have body. Body is the, you can consider it as the parent of all the rest of the content. And body specifies font weight as bold and color as red. And next we have div. Okay, division specifies, you can see the same properties are used here. Okay, then font body has a font as font weight as bold, color is red. In case of div, the font weight is normal, color is magenta, and in the paragraph we just have for the color is green, and we have one ID. Okay, so dot last, last is the ID name. Sorry, this is dot is a class. It's a class. Last is the class name, dot last, and inside that we have color as blue, and we have a one ID with a hash. And the ID name is very last. Inside the this particular selector, we have color as orange, and font size is 16 PT. Now, you can see here, this is the HTML code that we have. First one is we have this text is not within a P element. So the HTML, what we have, this is inside the body. So maybe the body is missed out here. This whole thing is inside the body tags. And inside the body, I have a text without any P. Just it is a plain text without using any P element. So for this, whatever is defined in the body, okay, that will be applied. You can see the first line. This says this text is within a P element. You can see it is the red. So whatever the style that is given to the body element, that will be applied to this text because it is inside the body element. Then inside the body we have a P, okay. So and we have text review for this P tag, that is paragraph tag. If you see here, the P is parent is a body. So the P is going to inherit the font weight and the color. But what has happened is for P, we have a specific style mentioned. We did not say anything about the weight here, only color. Now what happens is these two will naturally inherit to P. If I don't have any specific property defined in the P as a selector, but in case of a color, I am overriding the parent. So if I had, so assume that this P, this particular rule was not there, this P would have taken the same, parent is bold and color is red. This review would have been shown as bold and red, but P is very specific. Okay, P is whatever the style you have specified is very specific to this P tag, and you are writing overriding the color as green. Now what happens is from the parent it will inherit the font weight, that is bold. So font weight would be bold, and it will override the parent for the color property. So parent is red, the P will override it as green. So this particular text review will be shown as a bold and in green color. So you can see this is okay. You can see this is the second one, right? Then after P, we have div. Okay. So in case of a div, what happens? The div is also the descendant of the body. But if you see, both font weight and color are overridden. So whatever the elements inside this div, this property will override. Font weight will be normal. All this text inside the div will be shown as normal with the magenta. That is the color. So you can see here, div P. Okay. Inside the div, we have P, but P, we have very specific style here. Now what will happen? It will, P has two parent and a grandparent. The parent color it is going to override. Grandparent color says red and parent says magenta and P says green. So this P, this color will override both parent and grandparent. All this text, whatever the by Ricardo inside the P tags, it will be shown as green. However, if you see, there is no mention of the font weight, but his parent is saying normal, grandparent is saying bold. So in this case, it will, the next specific level is the div. So font weight would be normal. It will not be shown as a bold. If you see here, this is the text, okay, by Ricardo. It is shown in a green, but a normal, not bold. So this particular text and this particular text will be shown as a green normal font. And after that, inside div, I have one more text. This text is not within P element. So this text is just inside the div. This text is just inside the div. So whatever the property of the div will be applied to this. And what is the property of the div? Normal font weight and magenta. So you can see this is the text with the normal without bold, normal font and magenta color. And similarly for others, inside the div, again I have P. These two P will have this particular style, okay, and There are no other text. So next is the this division. Now you can see here inside this division I have p, okay, and also I have specified the class. Now what happens is this particular class will override. Now for this class, okay, I have if I see the ancestry, p is there on top of the p, div is there on top of that, body is there, but this class last has defined the color as blue. So even though its ancestors has different colors here, it will override. This particular class will override blue. So this text by day on will be shown in blue color, which is here. Okay, and of course the font weight would be normal because there is no font weight in the its parent, but its parent, that is div, has a normal. It will be shown in the normal. So this is blue is in the normal. The next one, we have class and is equal to last, and I have id is equal to very last. Now you can see id has the highest precedence. Okay, now if I see the ancestry for this id, id has a, on top of it we have a class called last, on top of it we have p, on top of it div, on top of it body, and this particular id has overwritten the color as well as, okay, it has overwritten the color, so it will override all these colors and it will show the text in orange. And also it has a new property, font size 16 pt, and since there is no font weight, the div has the normal. So this orange color with the 16 pt font size, it will be shown in the orange color. So you can see here id is more specific. Okay, id is more specific. Next is the class, then the particular tag, and if it is inside the one parent, it will inherit that, and whatever is on top of that parent, that is grandparent, that property, so it will go from your id, class, particular tag, whichever the tag you have, and then to the parent, whatever the ancestry you have, it will go in that fashion. When it is applying the style, it will start from the bottom. If it is specified here at the id level, it will apply that. If id is not there, let us say class is present, it will apply there. Both are not present, only particular tag is present, it will apply that. And particular tag specification is also not there, then it will go for the parent. If parent is not there, then it will go for the grandparent. If nothing is there, it will go to the whatever the default setting of the browser. Okay, algorithm. The algorithm that is used to determine the specificity. How the specificity is calculated is, first count one if the declaration is from the style attribute in the HTML, otherwise zero. So if you specify the style, that is as a inline inside the HTML tag, if it is present, you will take the count as one, otherwise you will give the zero. And let us consider that as A, and count the number of ID attributes in the selector, let that value be B. And first is style, then you will count how many IDs are there, ID attributes are there, and that value will be taken as B. Then count the number of other attributes and pseudo class in the selector. Suppose if there are other attributes or pseudo classes, you will take the count. Okay, that will be considered as C. And count the number of element names and pseudo elements in the selector. So if there is any element name or the pseudo element name in the selector, you will consider it as that particular count as D. And finally, we will concatenate the four numbers A, B, C, D. Okay, just concatenate. This is not an addition. Just we'll place that number one beside another, and that will give the weightage together to calculate the selector's specificity or the weight. So with the example, you will understand how that is done. Okay. Here is the example. Now, if you see here, we have a div. Okay, the first number Okay. Count the number of, so here a style is not there in this particular example. Okay, sorry. In this particular example, style is not used. Okay, that is zero. There is no class. There is no ID. Only we have the element last D. I will show you again the D. Count the number of element names and pseudo elements in the selector. So that value will come. So we will get, because we have only div, we have 0, 0, 1. Next, you can see descendant selector elements only. Now, in div space form, okay, div followed by the form. So there are two elements, 1, 2. So it would be 0, okay. 0 is, the first 0 is inline style. Inline style is not there. No ID, no class. We have two elements. So 002. If you compare this with this one, so its specific value, specificity value is higher. And this will override this one. And if you see the next one, dot example, and inside that certain property is there. So if you see here, inline style is not there. ID is not there. But we have the class. Dot is what? It is a representation of the class. You will give a value of 1. And the last one is element. Element is 0. So if you see now, the specificity of this is a 10. So it is much higher than this one. So this would override this one. Clear? Then next is we have a ID. Hash first example. And we have the color. Now you can see. For when I am giving the code for this, inline 0, ID, yes, we have ID 1, ID, class 0, and this element 0. So if you see, the specificity is 100. It is more than this. ID has, sorry, class has 10, ID has 100. Okay, so this will override this one. And the next example is, I have ID plus additional selector. Now I have one div is there, then I have ID, hash first example, and inside that I have the property of the color. Now if you consider, first one is inline 0, there is no inline. Second one is for the ID, ID is 1, and the third one is for the class, no class, element I have 1. So it is 101. If you see here, compared to this, its specificity is higher, so it will override. And the last one is div style is equal to color. So we have used inline style. So inline style, the first A is the inline style. We will give 1 and rest are 0. It is 1000. So it will override all other things. This is how it is calculated. Is it clear how that specificity is calculated? Answer yes or no in the chat. So based on that specificity, you will come to know which particular style will be applied. Is that clear? Okay. Thank you. Okay. So that is the specificity. So you will come to know how the particular style is applied. You need not calculate these values looking from this. So whenever we have inline, that is the highest priority, then comes the ID, okay, next highest priority, then it is class, then particular tag, then the parents, okay, n number of parents. That is how the priority will go. It will start from the lowest, that is inline, ID, class, then tag and the parent. Next one is the location. When inheritance and specificity cannot determine style precedence, the principle of location will be used. So if there is, let us say, for certain example, you get the same specificity, okay? Inheritance also, using these two means, let us say, in some scenarios, we are not able to identify what priority should be given. Then comes the principle of location. That principle of location will be used. The principle of location is that when rules have the same specificity, then latest are given more weight. Okay, when we have let us say the we do the calculation and we come up with the two values which are exactly the same specificity at that particular time, whichever comes the latest, okay, by location, okay, that will be given the precedence. So we'll see the example, then you'll understand. So here is the example. This is the HTML document. I have head here, head starts here, and head will end here. And inside the head, I'm linking the CSS file style sheets. I have two style sheets. One is href styles a.css, and second one is styles www.css. I have two styles which I am linking with this particular HTML document, and also I have the style tags in the head section. Okay, this is embedded style. In that, I have hash example, and I have two properties: color orange, color magenta. And this is the closing style tag. This is closing head. So this is the head. In the head, I have two external files. One is styles a.css, styles www.css that are linked. On top of that, I have also embedded style. And in the body, what do I have in the body? P for the paragraph ID. ID is equal to example. So this ID would be present in one of the external files, as well as this is present here. So you can see hash, this is the ID that is used in this particular P tag. Style is equal to color colon red, and this particular text, sample text, it is not inside the P, but it is inside the body. Now we'll start from the we looked into the HTML. Now we will look different CSS files and its contents. You can see here, first one is the browser's default style settings. If you don't have any styles mentioned, this browser default styles will be applied. Then comes the user style.css. Some, let us say you have some user defined settings are there. If that is present, this style will override browser settings style. Okay, now and on top of the user style, we have our own external CSS file. For example, styles dot styles a.css. Inside it has a ID selector and color is green. Other thing, okay, this particular settings will override user style. And I have included one more style, that is styles www.css. Here it is green, in this it is green, in this color is blue. So this particular style will override this. That means the color blue will be overridden by the green. Then after that, I also have the embedded style, same hash example, color is orange and color is magenta. Now this particular ID selector in the embedded style will override the external file. Okay, so browser setting is overridden by user style. User style is overridden by the first CSS file. First CSS file setting is overridden by the second file, and second file setting is overridden by this particular embedded style hash example. If you see, it is all hash example because we are considering only hash example, which because there is an ambiguity. We have this particular ID defined at multiple locations. That is why we are trying to find which one to apply. Okay, now this will override external file. In the rule itself, there is a again ambiguity. First it says color is orange, then color is magenta. Now the second location, this will override the first one. Okay, this will override the first one. Now inside the body, I have PID is equal to example, and I have specified the style here. Style is equal to color red. When we have the inline style will override this one. Okay, And that is how this particular text, whatever we have in this particular tag, okay, sorry, this is the opening tag and this is the closing tag. Sample text is inside this p tag. So this p text will be shown in the red color. So why red color? Because this is going to override all these things. Okay, now the question is, I will show you the code. What color would the example text be if there wasn't a inline style definition? Means what? What is the question? I will give you 2 minutes to think over that. What they are saying, if suppose there is no inline text here, okay, inline style is not mentioned, this particular style is equal to color red, if this is not present, which color will the sample text be shown as? Okay, you have to answer that. I will show you the code. Okay, I had that example for the specificity also. Just I will show that. Okay. Okay, this is a example we just looked earlier PPTs. Okay, this example specificity, this particular not this, in this example I have a code for that. So this is how it will look like, and the code I have already explained. Okay, so body, whatever is in the PPT, so body is what? Font weight bold red, div is normal magenta. So this is bold red, normal magenta, same thing is translated here, and paragraph color is green, I have class color is blue, and I have ID color is orange, and font size is 16, and I have the same text. Okay, so you can see here this text is shown in bold red because if you see the body has, it will apply this bold and red. And next, the p reviews, even though it is inside the body, it will inherit the body, but the p has its own specific style, it is green. Okay, color is green, and it will inherit from div as well as body, and inside the div font weight is normal, that's why it will show the font as normal, and the weight, sorry, it is inside the body, not in the division, so it will directly inherit the bold. Okay, bold, and it will override the color red, this parent color, and it will override with the green color, so it is bold green. Similarly, this comment is inside the body, inside the body it will be shown as red bold, and this is this particular p is inside the div, div is inside the body. So this will inherit from div as well as body, and if p has defined, then it will override. Color is green, but it will shown with the normal green, and font weight is normal, same is the next p, and this text, okay, this is not in the p, it is in the div, so div has font weight normal, color is magenta. So color is magenta. So this is how this is shown. Okay, the last one, it has this paragraph. Okay, by Dave on. Okay, here the last ID, this is the ID. ID has specified the color as blue. Okay, you can see color is blue. That's why this text is shown as blue. And the last one, color is orange, and so font size is increased to 16 pt. You can say color is orange. You can see the last one. The class is last and id is very last. So id is going to override everything, class and the p and the div and the body. It's going to override everything else. Okay, then we will see the example for the location. Okay, this is the location. Let me open the code for the location. Okay, now you can see here I have a CSS file dot two CSS files that I have included here. Okay, I have this file style a styles a dot CSS, color is green, and styles www dot css, color is blue. Those two files are included here, and href, it's inside the CSS. You will not see any change here because earlier those files were not available. Okay, it was in the CSS, just I gave the folder as CSS. Now you can see this particular text. What is the text here? The sample text. There is nothing else in the HTML document. Inside the body, we have just only one paragraph, and for this p we have specified the id and we have specified the style is equal to color red. So this particular thing will override everything else, okay, because with respect to the location, with the closest location, the color what it is specified is red, so it is going to override everything else. Now the question is, if I remove this color, okay, this particular style, what will happen? Which color the text will be shown? You can unmute and answer, or you can put it in the chat. What color the text would be? Right now it is showing red. What I mean is, if I remove this style, okay, let us say if I do like this, okay, and if I save, what color the text would be shown? Can you answer? What color it would be? Can you make a guess? This is the code. Okay, no idea. Orange or magenta, which one? You have to be very specific. One color it will show, it will not show both. Vijay, very good. It is magenta. So location, location wise, if you see, this is the closest, okay, that is why it will show as magenta. Just I will show you. I have already saved, I have made this changes and I have saved it. I will refresh. Okay, it will show as magenta. Suppose if I had this, I saved it, now it will show orange. So it will, because this is the one it will show. And let us say this particular thing was missing. If I just remove that part, if this is missing, whatever we have specified in this, okay, that will be shown. And what we have specified in that file, I think it is blue, www.cs, edit. Okay, it is blue. And let us say we remove this also. Okay, instead of removing, I will remove its link. I will say CSS1, which is not present. Okay, and I will save this. Which color it will show? It will show this. Now it will not find here, it will go to this, which is green. Okay, if I open that particular CS styles a.cs, okay, it is green. And if I remove that reference also, if I remove this also, now which color it will show? Now what it will do? I remove, now basically there is nothing, okay, no styles. Okay, these CSS1 means just I removed that reference, it won't find it. So it is not finding it. So what it will show? It will show the whatever is the default browser settings. So by default, it browser shows the default as black and the normal. So that is how you will see. Now I just reverted, it is showing orange because it is present here. If I put here the style, whatever the color, then it will show that particular style. So it is based on the location. Okay, so here the guess is like if we remove this one, okay, if we remove this one, it will show the next one magenta. If I remove the magenta, it will show the orange. If I remove this whole thing, it will show this blue color. If I remove this one, it will show the green. If I remove this, if whatever is specified in the user styles, it will show that. And if there is nothing, if user styles.cs is not present, whatever is the browser setting. So here I did not include this. So whatever is present in this particular file, it will show that. Whatever is browser's default style, it will show that. Okay, there is one exception to the principle of location. Okay, if property is marked as exclamation important in an author created style rule, then it will override any other author created style regardless of its location. So if we use this particular exclamation important, then it will override everything. So it will, irrespective of what location it is, this particular property will override everything. The only exception is a style marked with a exclamation important in an user style sheet. Such a rule will override all others. So if it is a author created, then it will override all the author created. And if it is in the user style, then it will override everything else. So that completes the CSS different way. Whenever there is a overlapping, then how that overlapping is taken care, which style is selected, it is according to those three things, inheritance, either it is based on the inheritance, or it is based on the specificity, or it is based on the location. Now, every HTML element, there is a box element, okay? So every CSS, every tag that you are seeing, it comes with a box element. And that particular box element has some properties. For example, is the margin. So what is the margin is? Inside that box element, whatever the margin you specify. So this is the consisting around the particular that HTML element. So you have the HTML element, and outside it has a box element. Okay, by default the box element margin and everything would be zero, no image, nothing, so you won't visibly see that. But when you set the margin, margin is basically this area, like whatever the horizontal, vertical, all around the element, whatever you have the element, and when you specify the margin, it will give that margin in all the four sides. And you can specify using a margin. It can be specified as a direct unit. You can specify like 10 pixel or something like that, or you can specify the percentage. So percentage will be taken from the parent, and it will have a background color and background image. So this would be like it is enclosing the HTML element. So it would be like a parent. This box element is a parent to the whatever the HTML tag you have. So you can specify the background color for that. You can also specify the background image for that particular box element. Now, inside, okay. Inside we have the properties. Once we have the HTML tag, the HTML tag can have a border. So all along it can have a border, and also it can have a padding. What is the padding? Is from that border. So you will both horizontally and vertically in all direction, you want to have certain padding, okay? So some 5 pixels or 10 pixels, that you can specify using the padding property. And additionally, the element, okay, the element will have a content area, and that content area is defined by two properties, width and the height. So every element has a width and height. When you don't specify, so far like for all the elements we did not specify anything. What it will do is it will take the default, whatever is the default, it will take that. And this particular border that you are seeing for the HTML element, we can specify the background color as well as a background image for that particular HTML element. The background color or image of an element fills an element out to be its border. So with around the all covering all the border, it will display whatever the color, background color you are selecting or image you are selecting. In contemporary web design, it has become extremely common to use CSS to display purely presentational images such as background gradients and patterns, decorative images, etc., rather than using the IMG element. So IMG element, it is a content based, okay? So your HTML document needs to have some figures, some block diagrams, things like that. You will use the image. And if you are using the images for the presentation purpose, example background image and those kind of a things, then you will use the CSS. So all this properties that has been given along with the CSS, you will use that. So what are the properties? Background first is the first property that we saw is a background property. It is a combined shorthand property that allows you to set the background values in one property. Okay, so background is a one combination. You can give the combination values, and you can specify all this in one go, or you can break it as a different properties. So for combined shorthand, you can use the background. While you can omit the properties with the shorthand, do remember that any omitted properties will be set to their default value. Suppose in the background, you can specify all these things, okay, and it would be in the same order. Let us say you miss something, then what will happen is whatever is the default value for, let us say you miss the background position, okay? When you miss the background position, whatever is the default position, that will be assigned. Then background attachment, this is another property. Specify whether the background image scrolls with the document, that is the default, or remains fixed. Possible values are fixed and scroll. So for this, there are what will happen is provides the background image, whether it has to scroll along with the document or it should not. It should say fixed. Suppose you have a background image and there is a scrolling. When you are scrolling, the background image should also scroll with the content, or it should remain fixed. By default, it will scroll. Okay. and the possible values are fixed and scroll. Background color, you can set any color for the background of the element. Background image, specify the background image, which generally is a JPEG, GIF or PNG file for the element. Note that the URL is relative to the CSS file, not the HTML. Okay, so this is one important thing you have to remember. So far what we did was like folder where your HTML file was present, that was considered as the root, and from there you navigate. But in case of this background image, the CSS file, location of the CSS file, for example, all our CSS file we have put in inside the CSS folder. So relative to that folder, so that will be taken as the root. From there you can go as a sibling folder or a child folder, a parent folder. That is how you should keep the images which you are selecting for the background. Background position specifies where on the element background image will be placed. Some possible values include bottom, at the bottom, or center, left, right. You can also specify a pixel or percentage numeric position value as well. When supplying a numeric value, you must supply horizontal and vertical pair. The value indicates its distance from the top left corner. Okay, so different positions of the image you can have is like these are the different either bottom, center, left, right. Those are the position. And suppose if you are giving a position with respect to horizontal and vertical values, then from the top left it will be considered. Suppose if you say 10 pixel and 50 pixel, it is with respect to the top left corner. Background repeat determines whether the background image will be repeated. This is a common technique for creating a tiled background. It is in fact the default behavior. Possible values are repeat, repeat X, repeat Y, and no repeat. There are examples for all those things. It will be more clear when we select that. So background repeat means what? Let us say your element is much bigger and your image is small, and by default it will repeat. Okay, it will repeat. You have a small image and it is trying to fill the complete background repeatedly, so it will get a look of a tile. So if you want to have a tiled look, then you can turn on the repeat. Repeat X is repeat will repeat on X direction as well as Y direction. If I say repeat X, it in the X direction only it will repeat. Okay, it will not repeat on the Y direction. Similarly, vice versa, repeat Y is it will repeat only on the Y direction. And you can say no repeat means whatever is the image, it will just be shown, it will not repeat. And by default, the value is set as repeat. Background size. Okay, new to CSS3, this property lets you modify the size of the background image. So if you want to change the image of your background, if you want to resize, then you can use this particular property. Okay, so we have examples. We will look into the examples in the next session. Okay, so basically this is a box model. So box model gives you an idea. This is very, very useful with respect to the presentation. So it talks about all this, like what are the margin you can have for the box element, then box element, parent box element, background color, background images. And for the element itself, it has a border, it has a padding. Padding is the space you are giving in all the four sides, and element itself will have a width and the height. So we'll see in the more examples in the next session.